Can I call now on our next speaker, Dr. Alireza Mousavi-Jarahi from Iran, from Tehran, who will give us an overview of the situation regarding cancer registration in the Islamic Republic of Iran. No, you'll have to go the other way, unless you're very tall. Yeah. Who's not be talking?
Thank you very much. I would like to thank organizer for inviting me and giving me this privilege to talk about cancer and cancer control and cancer registry in Iran. Malcolm talked about the APOCP. In November last year, we had a regional meeting in Tehran that Anton was, participated from Russia. At that time, we decided to extend, in fact, APOCP's activity to as a chapter in our part of the, Asia, in Western Asia. I've been register a kind of NGO or a research kind of entity to undergo this West Asia chapter, and I'm hoping to get it done, and hopefully we start the network, doing networking in cancer registry and cancer control in this area. And recently, Malcolm put the responsibility of Asia Pacific Journal of Cancer Prevention to the shoulder of this chapter, and we hope to have help as well as networking and for this Asia Pacific chapter, and hopefully to have this Asia Pacific Journal of Cancer Prevention getting run in our area. Outline my presentation. I will show you. I will talk about Iran and then cancer registry in Iran and then cancer epidemiology and the result that we have got from cancer registry in Iran. Iran mainly divides in three regions. From geographic kind of point of view, divided in three sections. We have a Caspian littoral area. The weather and the geography is different from the other part. They have lots of rain, different kind of climate. Then we have central part, the desert. The population density is not that much. And then we have southern plateau and southern part of Iran, that the climate is very warm and the climate is almost tropical. The population in Iran is very young. 75% are less than 30 years. And young population means lower burden in cancer. However, the population is kind of is estimated by demographic will change in next 30 to 40 years, and we have a major problem with aging. Right now, the fertility rate is less than one, and with this fertility rate, it's expected that our population will age in near future, and that aging population will bring a big burden in terms of cancer. Iran's population is very diverse population. We have at least 10 different ethnicities living in this small in Iran. 50% of the population are Persian origin. Then we have Azeris, they are Turks, and Gilakis, that they live in Caspian littoral, Kurds, Arabs, and Baluch, and Turkmen, that they are living in different parts of Iran. And these ethnicities, they have different kind of cancer in terms of incidence and presentation. If you look at this, this is Caspian littoral. In the eastern part, we have Iranian Turkmens, and the western part we have Iranian Turks, and in the middle, Iranian Gilak. The incidence of cancer is very different. The whole area is, you know, it stretches almost 300 kilometers, but the incidence from in the eastern part is close to 150 per 100,000, and then in the Gilak part, in central part, comes to 50 something, and in the western part, again, incidence very high. And what I'm trying to tell that this diversity is in somehow translated in the cancer incidence. This is cancer mortality in 2000 that we reported, and if you see stomach cancer is number one, then I'll talk about the incidence of stomach cancer and different cancer. However, we have a lung cancer, liver cancer. This is mortality, and our mortality is very, mortality in fact for the cancer is sometimes misleading because misclassification problem. For example, if here we have lung cancer, liver cancer. Liver cancer is very rare in terms of incidence. However, in our mortality, we have a high mortality rate of liver cancer, and these are mostly attributed to the metastatic cancer. When it comes to history of cancer registration, the history of cancer registration in Iran started in 1956. In 1956, Iranian Pathologists Association, they collected all the retrospectively collected all the pathology-based cancer during last say 30 years, and they made their first report. In fact, that registry was a kind of case series. However, at that time report, that's the first report that we had regarding cancer in Iran. And that time, the pattern of cancer was reported as the non-Hodgkin lymphoma as the top cancer, and then cervical cancer and breast cancer like this. In 1969, IARC developed population-based cancer registries in northeastern part of Iran due to the report that was coming that there is loss of esophageal cancer in the northeastern part. At that time, they published a population-based. That population-based later on extended to the provinces and cities close to northeastern part of the country, and they published data, and they published at that time, they showed that there is a very high incidence of esophageal cancer in Turkmenistan area in Iran. In 1968, the same activity that IARC started in the Caspian littoral area extended to the Shiraz. Shiraz is kind of in central part of Iran. That's a central kind of population, central part of Iran. They published their data till 1980, and normally they published just frequency data. However, they were able to register cases of cancer, and now they don't publish anymore. In 1980, they ceased their activity. In 1984, a parliament passed a bill that cancer is compulsory. However, in 1980, there was no infrastructure. Even though there was a role that pathologists supposed to report cancer, however, there was not infrastructure to, if they want to report, where to report and to collect this data and to publish it. In 1994, in fact, to provide that infrastructure for compulsory reporting, the first pathology-based cancer registry was established. And then in 1996, IARC and Cancer Institute established a Tehran population-based cancer registry. And then in 2005, again, IARC and a few cancer research centers, they develop a five-province population-based cancer registry that the result end up that one of the provinces was able to put this data in Cancerify continent. I will talk about more about these three last cancer registries, because they are published population based. They publish relatively good data. Tehran population based cancer registry. That I was principal investigator, and I'm kind of principal investigator for this registry. Started in 1996. We had a meeting with the scientists from IARC, and we decided to establish a population based cancer registry in Tehran. We started with the just hospital-based cancer registry. We developed certain protocol for hospital to be able to keep their data, develop hospital-based registries. This hospital-based registry later on was extended to part of city, and 1998, the whole city, the whole Tehran metropolis was under population-based cancer registry. The objective of this population-based cancer registry was to estimate cancer incidence in Tehran metropolis. And why the method was data collection was active. It means that we need to actively collect data, and this active data collection brought in fact a major burden for the cancer registry. We collected data from pathology centers, hospital medical departments, sono imaging centers that later on we saw that, you know, we faced with lots of data that we were unable to, some of them to even interpret, and death certificate. We collect the death certificate from the Iranian vital statistic registration. Why the Tehran? Well, Tehran is a big city. Tehran is a large city. Population is 10 million people living in the Tehran. At that time, it was decided that if we have a Tehran population registered cancer registered in Tehran population, first of all, we were able to cover all the ethnicities, because Tehran is kind of a city that different ethnicity living in the Tehran together. Plus, it was, you know, we thought that Tehran hospitals are a hospital that they produce quality data. In other, say, cities far from Tehran, normally the data generated is not very in quality. We have the best diagnostic facility in Tehran. We have lots of treatment facility in Tehran, and we have better chance of follow-up in Tehran, say, compared to the other part of our country. That was the decision that was made to choose the Tehran population as the candidate population for cancer registry. The Tehran population cancer registry, in fact, collect data just very nominal and data. We collected name and place of residency, and we collected tumor data, ICD-OC, ICD-OM, incidence date, and then means of diagnosis and source of information. And and the aim was just to have incidence in the Tehran population, incidence of different cancer in Tehran population. This is the first result that we published in the Iranian Archive of Medicine, and the second row shows the our results for Tehran population-based cancer registry. If you look at stomach cancer, is the number one cancer in Tehran. The first row is Ardabil. Ardabil is a small city that in the north. Western part of Caspian littoral. It has a very quality registry. As you see, stomach cancer is number one in Tehran, and then we have lung cancer, colon cancer, and prostate cancer. That was a result that due to the we got from Tehran population-based cancer registry, and I have put other registries from, you know, in neighboring country, and it shows that, you know, our data somehow is compatible with the data from other countries. This is in data from Tehran population registry in females. As you see, stomach breast cancer. Breast cancer is number one. Then stomach is number two. And then we have cervical cancer. That's very, very, very low, and that's expected to be low for our population. We have non-Hodgkin lymphoma and leukemias, cancer that somehow are reported for female in Tehran population-based cancer registry. And if you look at Tehran population-based cancer registry, shows 31 per 100 population. This is age-adjusted. However, in the Ardabil registry, the small city, the incidence is very low. And this difference is would be due to the difference in the ethnic kind of ethnicity composition of the population. Then we had a pathology-based cancer registry. In 1990, that is 1984, in fact. In 1994, the Ministry of Health launched the pathology-based cancer registry, and they developed infrastructure, electronic infrastructure for the pathologists to report all the cancer to the main office. They've been publishing many books and many reports. These are, in fact, the books and reports that they have published since 1996 that they developed their this pathology base. However, this pathology base is a very kind of referral. It follows a referral pattern. If you look at this in northeastern part, that's a city called Mashhad. This is a very kind of developed city, and this high incidence area. In fact, this incidence is somehow pattern of utilization and pattern of kind of referral, and that's the problem. In fact, we have with this pathology-based registries. This is for male, and the same again. This for female. We clearly shows that there is some referrals, because in some part there is 38 per 100, then the other part is 100. 8 per 100,000, and this difference is somehow that's due to referral. Why is referral? Because the pathology report that is collected from our pathology center, normally they do not have the address. It means that when the report comes, we don't know this patient, if it is belong to which population. And this kind of problem made, you know, this referral pattern of incidents, that's the main problem, that the government tries to somehow address this problem, but it's not definitely easy, as they haven't been able to overcome this problem, though they've been able to make some effect and bring down the number of percent of at least report that they don't have an address, so that they can assign patient to the population. Then we have five province, province population-based cancer registry. These five provinces were kind of collaborative work with IARC. They, in five provinces that different parts of Iran, they collect data, population-based data. They've been able to publish one of these provinces in the Cancer in Five Continent. That's Mazandaran province. And this registry is working relatively good. They use the pathology report data. They add the population-based registry aspect. It means they collect data from hospitals. They collect data from other kind of source of that data is generated. I'm going to report in some, at least the three main cancer in Iran that, this data is based, this report is based on data from different cancer registries. We have esophageal cancer. Esophageal cancer is very common in Iran. However, this esophageal cancer in three different parts of the country, Tehran, that's from population, Tehran population-based cancer registry, Shiraz is from Shiraz kind of cancer registry, and Mazandaran is the data is from five five province cancer registry that shows esophageal cancer decreasing. In fact, all registry that has brought us at least this fact that be able to see the trend in the different cancer. And stomach cancer, we have a stable rate during this last, 10 years, stomach cancer has been stable, and colorectal cancer is increasing. And this result is coming from the data that we have collected and we have developed through the registries. Thank you very much. Very question.
Thank you very much, Dr. Mousavi. Have we got any questions, any comments?
Yes, please.
Thank you very much for your presentation. Thank you very much for your presentation. In fact, my question is to two previous speakers, both to Pakistan and to Iran. Thank you very much for your presentation. Of course, in your countries, you register not only the cancer incidence, but also you register the stage, both in Pakistan and Iran. See, you initially identified cancer cases, but you also identify the stage, but you collect information on treated cancers as well. That's why I'm interested to know what is the biggest group of cancers you identified, stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, when you first diagnose a patient with cancer. Is it phase 1, 2, or 3? Do you understand my question?
Definitely, definitely. In our population-based cancer registry, we do not collect information about the staging. However, this data has helped us to, be interested in this treatment and different stages. The data that we have in terms of internal diagnosis as a stage for breast cancer, or for breast cancer, 15 years ago, we had 60%, more than 60% diagnosed at stage 3. Due to different kind of intervention or people's kind of awareness, now this staging has come down, so that we have just 30% coming, with the stage 3. It means that we don't collect staging very kind of systematically. But different research centers, they are interested in this staging and collect data. And we have some good data for breast cancer, not necessarily for other cancers. I don't know. Did I answer your question?
OK. Any other questions, comments? If not, Shavit, ahead, OK.
I didn't get the translation for some reason, I think your question was about the staging.
Yeah.
Yes. What is the biggest percentage in stages, whether it's advanced or early stage of cancer, when you register in your country, whether it's early cancer or advanced?
Advanced. Obviously, it's advanced. Yes. In almost all cancers, if it's breast or head and neck, it's advanced. Yes, so stage 3, stage 4, these are more common than early stages. And just one thing to add, one of our province, that is Balochistan,
yes,
which is adjacent to
Iran
and Afghanistan, esophageal cancer is the most common cancer, even in females.
Yes.
Breast cancer is number two cancer. Esophageal cancer is number one cancer. And I was, you know, the last week the report came from IARC that they have concluded from some robust studies that hot beverages, they certainly have a strong association with esophageal cancer, and they have given the cutoff of 65 degrees centigrade, that if we drink tea or any beverage which is more than 65 degrees centigrade, you know, it has a strong association with esophageal cancer. And certainly, you know, we discard anything which is less than 65 degree. We like to drink hot tea, you know. Yeah. otherwise we say, you know, this is not a tea, this is a cold drink. So, yeah. You know, and
I
think...
You know, esophageal cancer has been high in Iran and especially in Balochistan like this. We don't know exactly what the etiology. Most probably what yesterday Dr. Chow said, the etiology is more related to nutrition aspect than hot, you know, hot beverage or the different kind of hypothesis. Some people, they say that, you know, there is a granite in bread, and then that granite goes to the, you know, visual cell, different kind of hypothesis. But most probably the nutritional aspect is very obvious as a risk factor. In Iran, the in the area that we have as high as visual cancer, the rate of fruit consumption is very low, very distinctly lower than other areas. And most probably that's the one of the major contributing to this high incidence of esophageal cancer.
Okay. So I think that people look as if they need a coffee. Certainly I need a coffee.
No hot coffee, yeah.
So thank you very much, Dr. Mousavi.
Thank you very much.
And since we have Dr. Kern Yung Yu, unfortunately, is not here, we have a little leeway. So instead of coming back at 11 o'clock, I would suggest that we come back at 11:15. So that gives us still a half an hour for our refreshing coffee break. Thank you very much for participants and the audience for this session.